That's all from the Ian and Esh. They're such brilliant filmmakers, and that's something they really loved, and it's in the movie, and I'm glad that it stuck with you for sure.
Yeah. And I suppose, Scott, can you tell us about your character, Vinny? Is he helping out at Cash? Is he on the noble side? Or I know Cash is torn between both fronts, really. But where does Vinny fall in? Or is he with Big Cash? Is he on the heroine, the heroness, dare I say, the evil queen, Andie MacDowell sort of character? Where does Vinny fit into all of this?
I think that in every family, there's that one person who really struggles with some sort of demons. You know, I mean, I'm not saying that every family has that, but I know a lot of families where there's somebody who drinks a lot and it's really disruptive in their lives, it's disruptive in their family's lives. They begin to financial situations. So I think Finney plays, you know, that role, if you will, in the family dynamic.
Yeah, so Vinny is almost like the lost sheep, sort of looking for redemption. He's looking to make his sort of where he fits in this life, where he sort of belongs, dare I say.
That's right. Exactly.
Yeah,
Yep.
yeah. And I suppose in terms of this, we get to see that when you pass life, it never sort of you never sort of escape us in terms of this movie. And that can be central for the character, Orlando Bloom's character, Cash, in terms of that sort of life. He sort of brought up with it. It's in his DNA, and no matter how he tries to distill it and say that it isn't part of him, it's part of a history, the bad elements come back to haunt him.
Exactly. They do. That's in that life, and that we do things and it come back to haunt us and we don't even know it. I'm glad, you know, that the movie plays so well in terms of you just really don't know where it's going to go or if he's going to make it through this event or what with the situation he's in. And I thought Orlando did a phenomenal job. It's such a pleasure to work with.
And tell us a bit, Scott, about the shooting, the terms of production of this movie. Where was it shot? Where did you shoot? And was it a long enough wrap? Did you get to do it before the strikes, in terms of that? Or was it a bit of interruptions or in terms of shoot filming?
Yeah, we filmed in Kentucky. It was beautiful. We had a lot of locals helping us on our crew. It was a really special time of year to be filming in Kentucky. It was during the Kentucky Derby.
Okay, fantastic.
So it was just a really special time. And it's kind of like the introduction you gave me when you look at my backdrop right now. It has this kind of very, you feel like you're in Kentucky for the first few images there, and it really transports you to that world. So yeah, really special time.
Yeah, and I suppose in terms of the cast, it's a real testosterone-driven cast. You've got some real characters there in terms of when we think about Garrett and Brian, and we all know Jeremy's work from Cold Case and so many projects down through the years. But it takes a fierce, determined lady to put her head above all these sort of male figures and sort of stand out in terms of holding the hand or holding the whip, dare I say. And no bigger woman than Andie MacDowell to fill those boots. And you really get the sense that she is the real sort of the tiger within this movie. If you cross her, dare I say, you're using up your lives. And she almost feels like a woman in nine lives. She seems Miss Untouchable, dare I say.
She's phenomenal. She's one of our greatest actors we've had, and I love what she did with Big Cat. You know, I did one, another movie with Andy called Only the Brave many years ago about a group of firefighters out of Prescott, Arizona, and I remember just seeing her there, and it's just such a drastic change what she does in this film. So it was just really fun for me. I didn't have any scenes directly with her, but when I watched the film, I just loved watching her on screen for every second.
And I suppose in terms of trying to tell the story and the gripping element and the family dynamic element in it as well, there's sometimes in these crime type of stories you can overplay the violence and it can deter from the sort of story that's trying to be told. But there's a nice sort of blend in terms of this. While there is an appropriate level of violence to go with the sort of storyline, it's not a dare I say, broken necks or sort of stuff or blood gouging. It's what we would normally expect from this sort of thing, but it doesn't take away from what the story and the producers and directors are trying to take you on this road in terms of the decisions and the double jeopardy element that's in play.
100%. Yeah, there's a lot of stuff going on in this film. That's what I love about it. It feels like it's got its foot on the gas the whole time. And if you let off for a second, you're going a different direction. It's really action packed. It's, you know, as an actor, you don't know how things are going to turn out. But when I watched it, all the action sequences, because, you know, those are pretty elaborate sequences we had to pull off. And they did such a good job. Like, I loved it.
And Scott, obviously getting to see it firsthand in terms of the stunts and the sort of effects and obviously dealing with live firearms and ammunition in terms of that sort of stuff as well. It can be sort of rigorous in terms of those sorts of shooting because you need to get every camera angle, you need to get every sort of scene and motion sequence to sort of to play out. It definitely does its part. It almost feels like there's a good sort of bank robber element sort of chase to these sort of stunt scenes.
Exactly. That's exactly right. Bank robber chase scenes. It feels like that. It feels like there's somebody who's always, this is a good way to put it.
Yeah. And I suppose, Scott, in terms of a roller coaster ride, does it take you through all these sort of emotions, this sort of film? Is there sort of gripping sort of heart moments, sort of real raw sort of family dynamic sort of stuff, so where we get to see a bit of tenderness between Cash and his daughter, for example, and that sort of family dynamic? Do we get to see maybe that home element play out as well? Is there certain scenes where it's just a home element? Do we get a sense of Cash's struggle, what he's fighting for?
Well, yeah. I mean, I don't want to spoil the movie, but there's a lot of moments in there between my daughter and the, you know, it's really hard when a father can't be there because of some ailment, whether it's the flu or alcoholism. And I've known so many people, my friends, even myself included, like when it comes to your parents, like they just always don't know that they're affecting you in such a negative way. And it's just heartbreaking, you know, because it's not like these parents intend to hurt their children. They're just living their lives and they have some ailment and then it like really hurts the kid. And obviously the drinking for Finney is definitely affecting, you know, his daughter in such a very serious way, but he loves her so much, you know. It's very common.
And I suppose one thing that struck, and I saw in most of the comments and the reviews, and obviously you can tell me if this is a bit of a natural in terms of that, but was it easy for Orlando Bloom to switch the flick of the hat and maybe get into that sort of Central American, that raw sort of Kansas sort of accent that we sort of see that is sort of peculiar that we wouldn't really associate with Orlando Bloom? Is he a man of varied talents when it comes to voiceovers and changing his voice to sound like someone else? Because this is the one thing that has struck many the reviews so far is the accent of Orlando Bloom in this sort of movie.
Well, I don't know what the reviews are saying. I haven't read them, but I know that he's phenomenal in the film. And I was blown away because there's certain, you know, you're in scenes with, you know, your co-star, and then the next thing you see other scenes you're not in. And just, I thought what he brought to the role was phenomenal. I do. I think that he's really solid. I thought he, you know, I don't really have an opinion on the accent other than I just loved his work in the film. You know, I've been there and everybody has very unique. If you're in like one holler is what they call it down there in yonder, there's many different accents if you're in one holler versus the other. And so the one he brought, I thought was just really interesting and great.
Yeah, certainly going down to rave reviews, positive reviews as well in terms of that. And I suppose, Scott, to wrap it up, I suppose February the 23rd is nearly around the corner. I suppose many people will be looking to go to the cinema screens, head out, whether it's plane, train, automobile, or who knows, even in rural Ireland, maybe the tractor might be the mode of transportation to get you to cinema. Arrive in the cinema, get to that sort of scene, your recliner seat, who knows, maybe put the feet up, have the popcorn, the Maltesers, the bottle of Pepsi, sit down, watch Red Right Hand for 90 minutes or 2 hours. And what's in store for them, Scott Hayes?
Imagine going up to the weirdest, most exciting, fun-looking amusement park. You get on a roller coaster and it doesn't let off until you get off the ride. It's just up and down. It's beautiful. It's a pleasure talking to you today. I'm mainly most of my heritage comes from I'm Irish, so
Okay.
I love your accent, yours, and
What
where
part, Scott? Is it west or east? Are we talking or Dublin or the west coast or up north as well?
Well, that's the thing is I plan to go to Ireland this year to figure that out. I'm a McNeil, my heritage from McNeil from some lineage. So I'm excited to go check it
More
out.
north, I'd say. More
Yeah.
north, I'd say, Scott. But there's three different accents in Ireland. One is the west coast, where I come from, southwest. Then you have your dub accent, and then you have your Northern Ireland. This is your Northern Ireland, which is a
Yeah.
strong sort of ring to it. So if you're practicing your accents in Ireland, there's three different types, and we all don't sound like Conor McGregor anyway, that's for sure.
That's for sure.
Scott Hayes, it's an absolute pleasure talking to you. We do encourage all our audience to go out on February the 23rd to check out Red Right Hand, featuring Scott Hayes as Vinny, Orlando Bloom as Cash, Andie MacDowell as Big Cat, Alexandria Park, Garrett Delahunty, Brian Geraghty, Jeremy Ratchford, the list goes on, an action-packed ride, and no doubt Scott steals the show with his role as Vinny. But for the moment, for me, Jim Conlan, to you, Scott Hayes, stay safe, take care, and God bless, sir.
Hey, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you. Take care, guys.